WebAssembly enables the use of low-level languages like Rust on the browser to execute complex calculations faster. In this video, you will learn how to compile Rust code into WebAssembly and run it on the browser. We will build a prime number checker on both WebAssembly and JavaScript, and comparing their performance on Firefox, we can see a big difference in speed between WebAssembly and JavaScript. WASM is more than 5 times faster. On Chrome, the WASM prime checker is 1 to 2 times faster on average. A bigger benefit of using WebAssembly comes to light when we try to check if a very large number is prime. JavaScript has a maximum safe integer of this value. It then screws up numbers larger than this. For example, this number which is prime changes to this. So when we test for prime, we get false, which is wrong. And for integers more than 17 digits, it rounds it off to 17 significant figures and adds zeros at the end. So we can't really test for prime for integers above 17 digits in JavaScript. We can solve this by changing from a number type to big int, but then computation becomes really slow, and you can try that after we build this project. So to set up a Rust WebAssembly project, first you need to have Rust installed. If you don't have Rust installed yet, you can do that by visiting this URL, and I'll add a link in the description. You also need Node.js and npm. Next, we'll install WASM pack. This will help us compile Rust code into WebAssembly. Run cargo install WASM pack. So we create a new directory for the project, and inside this directory, we create a new Rust project by running cargo new WASM and adding a lib flag, as this will be a library create. It will create a directory named WASM, and this is where we'll write all our Rust code. For our UI, we can use any framework or even vanilla.js. What matters is the bundler. There are different bundlers such as Vite and Webpack. Each bundler has its own configuration for running WASM files, but for this video, we'll go with Vite. Run npm create Vite to create a Vite project. We'll give it the name UI, and we have a list of frameworks to choose from. We will focus on the WebAssembly part first and move to the UI later on. The first thing we'll do is to add a Rust dependency called WASMBindGen. So in our terminal, we enter the WASM directory and run cargo add WASMBindGen. Next, we open up the cargo.toml file and add a lib table. Under it, we set the crate type to be a CYD lib and an arrow lib. This lets us compile the Rust library to be used in programs written in another language. You can learn more about other crate types from the link in the description. Lastly, under the release profile, we set the optimization level to S. This will let us prioritize for a smaller binary size during compilation, so it can be easily downloaded over the network. An optimization level of 3 will optimize for speed. We then open up the lib.rs file. For now, we just want to add WebAssembly to our web page, so we start by making Rust alert hello world in the browser. We clear everything on the lib.rs file and import the prelude from WASMBindGen. To let Rust call the alert function in JavaScript, we use extensC and define the alert function parameters type and return type if they exist, then add the WASMBindGen macro at its stop. We then define a greet function that we take a name parameter and call the alert function, passing in a string with hello followed by the name. For this to be used in WebAssembly, we add a WASMBindGen macro. We can then compile and use it in our UI. To compile Rust to WebAssembly, we use WASMPack, and inside the WASM directory, we run WASMPack build. When this is done, we can see a package directory that contains the compiled WASM file, a JavaScript and a TypeScript interface for it to be used within any JavaScript and TypeScript file. We want this package directory to be inside the source folder of the UI for it to be used directly. So we delete this, and in our terminal, within the WASM directory, we run WASMPack build, but set the output directory to be in the UI/source/pkg, and we can see it's where we want it to be. Before we can use the items within this package directory, after it's compiled to WASM, we need to run npm install. We will automate this process by writing an npm script that will compile the Rust code to WASM into the source folder of the UI and run npm install inside the UI directory. So at the root of our project, we initialize npm, open up the package.json and add a build WASM script that we enter into the WASM directory, run WASMPack build and with our specified output directory, then go into the UI directory and run npm install. We will also add a dev script that we go into the UI directory and run npm run dev. So from the root of our project, we execute npm run build WASM to build the WebAssembly. When this is done, we can then start up our application with npm run dev. In our browser, we can see the Vite TypeScript boilerplate, but we aren't getting the alerts yet. So back in our code, in the index.html file, we link the main.ts file. Now in the main.ts file, we import grid from pkg, and when we call this function, we need to pass in the name we are saying hello to, therefore we use world. Going back to our browser, we can see an error letting us know we need to have the Wasm plugin in our Vite configuration to enable Wasm. In the Git repo for this plugin, it says we also need a top-level await plugin. So in the UI directory, we install them both as dev dependencies. If you don't already have a vite.js.config file in your UI directory, create one, import define-config from Vite, and also the Wasm and top-level await plugins. Next, we export the define-config function and pass in our plugins. When we restart, we get our hello world alert and we have successfully run Rust on the browser. Now for testing prime numbers with WebAssembly. To get the UI for this, you can head over to this Git repository and update your index.html and style.css files. I use Tailwind for styling, therefore we install Tailwind with PostCSS and AutoPrefixer. After this is done, create a tailwind.config.js and a postcss.config.js file and update the files with the config from the repository. After restarting the server, we have our UI completed. We can now write the prime checker function on both Rust and TypeScript to compare their performance on different browsers. In the main.ts file, we create the isPrime function. If a number is not an integer or is less than or equal to 1, it can't be prime. We then iterate from I equals 2, and the condition is on I squared to be less than or equal to the number, and we increment I by 1. If the number is divisible by I, then it's not prime. If the loop is completed and we can't find an I from 2 to the square root of num that can divide num, then it's a prime. We do the same for Rust, but we pass in a string into the function. We then pass the string into an unsigned integer, and if it fails, we assign num a value of 0. The function is okay, but we need to support larger integers while optimizing for performance. So we create a prime checker function for 8, 16, 32, 64, and 122-bit unsigned integers. So we pass this string into an 8-bit unsigned integer. If it errors, we pass into 16 bits till we get into 128 bits. And if we can't pass into any of these, we return false. We then compile into WebAssembly, and back to the main.ts file, we create an app function, which we'll call at the end of the file. In the UI, when we enter a number, we submit a form that reloads the web page with a num query in the URL containing the number. So we get this number from the query, trim it, and if it's undefined, we return LA. We then get the slots for Wasm answer, Wasm time, JS answer, and JS time from the UI. Next, import the isPrime function from the package directory and calculate the execution time for both Wasm and JS. Then display these results within the element that should contain them. You can now test and compare each of them. To get a list of prime numbers, head over to this website and you can find prime numbers with the number of digits you wish to test for. Thanks for watching.